And we're back with you now on WZBN News. This is Mercer County Close Up. Across Hamilton Township, there are many outreach initiatives, one of which is Ryan's Quest, the very well-known one, which targets the young man who has Duchenne muscular dystrophy. Funds are always pouring in thanks to the goodness of Hamilton residents and those that even live outside the township. Well, at Nottingham High School, there was an effort spearheaded by a sophomore at the school and his friend. One of the gentlemen is here today to talk about something that has just passed, but also an event coming up on April 7th that hopefully a lot of people will show up for, at least, and if they can't, hopefully they'll donate funds for. Joining us to talk about both these neat initiatives that were brain children of his and his friend is Nick DeMarie, a sophomore at Nottingham. Nick, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Well, Make Noise for Kids. I hear that it was this nationwide event, or at least it tried to go national, but you folks localized it to Nottingham High. What did you folks do there?
Well, what Make Noise for Kids is, it's a New Jersey state organization, a nonprofit, and the goal is to raise money and awareness for pediatric cancer. Mm-hmm. And what we did at Nottingham, my friend Scott, Rob, and I, was to take it upon ourselves to raise money for this organization. What we did, we launched a awareness ribbon, blow pops, mm-hmm. and we did this in our lunch period. And our goal was to raise $1,000 to benefit pediatric cancer research via the organization.
Yeah.
We were very successful. We reached our goal of $1,000. So it was a really great thing to become involved in, and my friend Scott and I are very successful.
Right. $1,000 is certainly not chump change. And, of course, when you think of high school, you know, if you're lucky enough to have a part-time job, it probably doesn't pay you, you know, much beyond minimum wage. Some of us, you know, mm-hmm. some that are lucky enough to have high-paying jobs at 16, 17 can make it. But, I mean, what was the response like at Nottingham? Obviously, I mean, you folks as sophomores have got lots of friends who probably jumped right on board with this. But did you have tell me about the challenges and also the successes with getting the money raised.
Well, the biggest challenge that we faced through this was just getting a great amount of support from the get-go.
Mm-hmm.
It took a little while, probably about a week or two, before we started getting the school aware of what we were doing. And once we got it going, though, people were surprisingly generous. I know there's tough economic times, but students were, you know, always kind-hearted and willing to, you know, support. We would go to our lunch period and we would collect. We were also able to, if we had study hall or free periods, go and collect whatever we could. And, mm-hmm. Fortunately, we were able to raise, our $1,000.
That's great. I know you had to do a lot of campaigning, probably mm-hmm. post a lot of banners, even get the word out via word of mouth. Mm-hmm. And there was also something mingled into all that called Dress Down Day. What was the correlation there?
What we did, because we were close to our goal, mm-hmm. we weren't quite there. So we decided that we wanted to open this up more to the staff and the administration. So we approached our teacher, Mrs. Pandolfini, mm-hmm. Who is very active in the school with her different fundraisers and things like that. And we confronted her and our administration, and we asked them if it would be okay if we could hold a dress down day on a Friday, you know, in which the teachers could wear casual clothing, jeans, to support the Make Noise for Kids. And our principal, Mr. Michael Gambaluca, and vice principal, Mr. Frank Ragazzo, were very open to this. They, you know, allowed us to do it, and it was very successful. We raised a lot of through that.
It's always nice to hear when teenagers are starting their own grassroots efforts, which grow into a school-wide campaign with many people jumping on board towards the same cause. And when it grows into a national thing based on other people's efforts elsewhere, it's always very wonderful. Now, the efforts are continuing on your own front. I know that there's an event coming up on Saturday, April 7th in Veterans Park. Should be a beautiful day. We'll be a couple weeks into spring. What is happening on April 7th?
Well, on April 7th, what we are doing, Scott and I, mm-hmm. with Nottingham, we are going to begin this week in school raising money for the Race for Hope with Rye,
mm-hmm.
which is a 5K walk run. And what we are planning to do with that is set up a team from Nottingham through students making a donation. And we plan to have a team to bring to the run. We'll get shirts and signs and et cetera. And it's a $20 donation, mm-hmm. so if a student donates that, they'll be able to get a shirt and be marked down as on the team. And we're going to try to get as many kids as we can from school to go and, support the great cause.
Yeah, when you think about kids your age, you want to, you know, competition makes it friendly, too. It is a race, more or less. It's a 5K walk, so you can pretty much go at any pace you want. But, I mean, getting kids together, you know, if they all agree on the same thing, that makes it more fun with the camaraderie and all, I'm sure. By the way, it's called the Race for Hope with Rye 5K Walk. It's not the Ryan who you hear about with Ryan's Quest, but a different Ryan who's older. He's in his 20s and has had one surgery already because of a brain tumor. Fortunately, it is operable, but he, like the folks that were involved with Make Noise for Kids, they need your help and you know, anything you can donate as far as funds to help this help more surgeries come along for him. And there will be ways for people to donate if they can't go to the race itself.
Yes, what at Nottingham we will go like we did with the previous event to our lunch periods at the end of the day whenever we have the chance, and we'll just ask kids if they could make a small donation, even if they can't, you know, allocate the 20, if they could just donate 5, 10, less even, you know, just to support, and so we could put more money, you know, toward Ryan.
Right. Would there be, I mean, is the best suggestion for even folks watching out there who might not have kids at Nottingham, should they just stop by the office and make a donation in person, or is there a website, anything like that?
They could do that, or they could try to contact Ryan directly.
Okay.
You know, we could provide information, I'm sure, on that. But, you know, Nottingham, in Nottingham, we would be willing to, you know, talk to anybody that was willing to donate, you know, and take that on.
Excellent. Well, you know, Nick, thank you so much for being our guest today. It's always great to hear when, you know, kids like yourself are doing this. And congratulations on Make Noise for Kids being a success. We hope the same comes for the Race for Hope with Rye 5K Walk. And thank you for being
thank
our guest.
Thank you very
much. No problem. Nick DeMaria, sophomore at Nottingham High School. The event's still to come Saturday, April 7th in Veterans Park. It'll start what, in the morning, by the way?
Did we have a
start time, 8 a.m. or so?
Yeah, sometime around then.
To be announced still. Okay, so definitely make plans if you can participate in the 5K walk. $20 donation, but you get a free T-shirt, and you get it'll be a fun day. Hopefully the weather's beautiful. If you can't partake in the walk, stop by Nottingham High School and make a donation in person. No amount is too small nor too large. I'm Mark Fontes. Thank you for joining us on this Mercer County Close-Up. We'll see you again really soon.